discussing about the Monera, Protista, and then fungi. We have discussed up to the fungi, and today I'll tell you something about the kingdom plantae. But in this chapter, they have just given you the idea about the kingdom plantae. It is a third chapter. It's totally dedicated for this kingdom plantae. Basically, it's a plant kingdom. This includes all eukaryotes, because you know that protistan, fungi, plantae, animalia, they are all eukaryotes. Only one kingdom, that is Monera, is for the prokaryotes. So kingdom plantae, there includes all eukaryotic chlorophyll containing organism, and they call plants. They are having cellulosic cell wall, and some of these members are partially heterotrophs also, just like insectivorous plants or parasites. Example, Venus flytrap and bladderwort, they are insectivorous plant. Cuscuta is a parasite. The cell wall of eukaryotic type structure with prominent chloroplast and cell wall containing cellulose. And this kingdom includes following classes: algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperm, and angiosperm. The members of this kingdom have two distinct phases: that diploid sporophytic phase and haploid gametophytic phase. And this is called alternation of generation. Basically, होता क्या है plants में कि जो sexual reproduction है, sexual reproduction में क्या बनता है, gametes बनते हैं, और गैमेट फ्यूज करके क्या बनाते हैं, जाइगोट बनाते हैं. तो जाइगोट से जो बॉडी बनेगी वो बनेगी स्पोरोफिटिक, और आगे स्पोरोफिटिक में मियोसिस होगी, तो मियोसिस होके अगेन गैमेट्स बनेंगे. तो एल्गी और जो ब्रायोफाइट्स हैं, दे आर हैविंग, उनकी जो प्लांट बॉडी है दैट इज हैप्लॉइड. एल्गी और ब्रायोफाइट्स की जो मेन प्लांट बॉडी है वो क्या है, हैप्लॉइड. और जो टेरिडोफाइट, जिम्नोस्पर्म और एंजियोस्पर्म है, इसमें जो मेन इनकी प्लांट बॉडी है दैट इज डिप्लॉयड. बिकॉज लोअर प्लांट्स में क्या है, इनकी हैप्लॉयड प्लांट बॉडी है. हैप्लॉयड प्लांट बॉडी क्या बनाती है, गैमेट्स. गैमेट फ्यूज होके क्या बनाते हैं, जाइगोट. तो जो डिप्लॉयड फेज है वो उसे बोलते हैं स्पोरोफाइट, और जो हैप्लॉयड फेज है उसे बोलते हैं गैमेटोफाइट. तो प्रीडोमिनेंट स्टेज जो है एल्गी में दैट इज गैमेटोफाइट, और एंजियोस्पर्म में द प्रीडोमिनेंट स्टेज इज स्पोरोफाइट. स्पोरोफाइट विल गिव राइज टू गैमेटोफाइट, and gametophyte give rise to sporophyte. So that is called alteration of generation. जैसे रात के बाद दिन आता है, दिन के बाद रात आती है, ऐसे ही जब वो sporophytic मतलब diploid होते हैं, तो diploid से haploid बनते हैं, और haploid से फिर diploid बनते हैं. This is called alteration of generation that we will discuss in detail when we discuss the plant kingdom. In animal kingdom, you know that the animal kingdom contains heterotrophic eukaryotic multicellular organism, and they lack cell wall. Okay, the main source of food for animal kingdom are plants, directly or indirectly. They digest the food in the alimentary canal, and it is reserved as a glycogen or fat. And the mode of nutrition is holozoic, or by ingestion of food. A definite growth pattern is present. Adults have definite shape and size. Higher form have well developed sensory and neuromuscular mechanism that is not there in the plants. Locomotion is present in all, well, not all but mostly in animals. Sexual reproduction occurs by copulation followed by fertilization of gametes and embryonic development. We will discuss more in this fourth chapter. Okay, the third one is for the plant and the fourth one is for the animal. Okay, so now I'll discuss about the viruses, viroids, prions and lichens. Nowadays in the TV media or in everywhere you heard about coronavirus. So I think everybody knows nowadays about the virus. It is nothing new to tell you about this. But you know, it is a connecting link between living and non-living, because virus don't have any cell. In the first chapter, we have discussed that for a living thing, for a living organism, the characteristic feature are that they have a cellular structure. They are made of cells. That's why we call cell is a basic unit of life. So if they don't have cell, because it is acellular, that's why it is comes under non-living. And why we call it as living? Because when it enters into the host, it will start replicating, mate replication, so metabolically active. So that's why it has a characteristic for both non-living and living. So that's why we consider viruses as a connecting link. So in the five kingdom classification given by the Whittaker, they have nowhere classified virus, viroids, and lichens in any groups. That are the shortcomings of the five kingdom classifications. And they are acellular or non-cellular. They are truly non-living. So they are not included in the classification. Because they have given that they are not truly living. And the virus are non-cellular. And you can correct, it is a correct, you can characterize, the non-cellular characterization is that you can make a crystal structure outside the living cell, and the inner virus, innate virus outside the cell is called virion. These are obligate parasite, means they cannot complete their life cycle without a specific host. They do not have a biosynthetic machinery. Once they infect the living host cell, they take over the machinery of the host cell and they replicate themselves and killing the host. And different viruses have different type of like incubation period. First time the name virus was given by the Louis Pasteur. Louis Pasteur was a very great scientist. You know that pasteurization is a technique which is used by the name of Pasteur. It is not a completely sterilization like nowadays you get milk in packets. They are all pasteurized. So that word comes from the Louis Pasteur, is a great microbiologist, or even father of microbiology. And he has given the name virus. Virus means that venom or poisonous fluid. And D.J. Vanovsky in 1892 recognized certain microbes as causative organism of mosaic disease of tobacco. So it means that virus is not new for us. They are like in the environment from the very beginning of starting of life, because they are the connecting link between the life and non-living. So they are in the evolutionary tree. If you discuss, so virus are the first to be present on the earth, and they are not new for us. We know it from, I think, around 200 years before. So, but there are the different type of viruses. They are now discovered. So M.W. Bejerinck is a scientist. He demonstrated that the extract of the infected plants of tobacco, it could also infect the healthy plants. And he called that fluid as a contagium vivum fluidium. Means that infectious living fluid, that extract of that plant, who do it, that who is infected by the mosaic virus. M.W. Stanley in 1935 showed that the virus could be crystallized, and the crystal consists largely of proteins. You have to remember the names, like there are 3-4 scientists. Their contribution is very significant in this virus. You can see the virus is ultra microscopic. Okay, it is very, very small, even thousands of times smaller than the bacteria. It is ultra microscopic nucleoprotein entity. It is having only the nucleic acid and the DNA and the protein. Size of the virus ranges from 10 nanometer, like foot and mouth virus of cattle, 70 nanometer alpha mosaic virus, 12-15 × 40 nanometer beet yellow virus. TMV size is 300 × 50 nanometer. Parrot fever virus is 400 nanometer. Like all different viruses having the different size. They are having a different shape, like spherical, cubical, helical, polyhedral. So different viruses having different shapes. So viruses having the protein coat that is called capsid, and a genetic material that is called either DNA or RNA, but not both. The envelope, the genetic material is infectious. Generally, virus that infect plants have single-stranded RNA. and virus that infect animals have either single or double stranded RNA or double stranded DNA. The envelope structure of virus is, it is outer covering present in certain virus. It is made up of protein of viral origin, lipid and carbohydrate of host. Protein जो होगा वो viral origin का होगा और lipid and carbohydrate जो होंगे of host origin के होंगे. Spikes or outgrowth may or may not be present. Like some common envelope virus are HIV, herpes virus, vaccinia virus. जो आज की डेट में mutations की बात हो रही है कि there is a double mutant, triple mutant. So actually there is a mutation they are saying in the spikes of the, that is outgrowth in the capsid. Capsid क्या हो, जो उसमें mutations है जिसकी through ये अपना DNA, RNA. क्योंकि RNA से, it's a retrovirus. It first make the cDNA and then it replicates. So the capsid is a protein covering around the genetic material. Capsid has protein subunit called capsomeres. उसको हम बोलते हैं capsomeres. TMB has 2130 capsomeres. And these capsomeres are arranged helically or in the geometric forms. That depends upon the different type of viruses. Here we have discussed mainly about the TMB because it was the first virus that was discovered. The nucleoid, it contains genetic material either DNA or RNA, but never both. Most of the animal virus have the double-stranded DNA as genetic material, while majority of plant virus have single-stranded RNA as genetic material. Enzymes are rarely present in the viruses. Lysozymes are found in bacteriophages. Bacteriophages are those viruses, those infect the bacteria. In some RNA viruses called retroviruses, RNA polymerase reverse transcriptase enzymes are present, and these reverse transcriptase means they convert their RNA to cDNA, because DNA replicate only, RNA cannot replicate. That's why they first convert mRNA to DNA. Based on the presence of DNA, RNA viruses are divided into two main groups, DNA viruses or RNA viruses. DNA viruses also called deoxyvira. These are generally animal viruses. Few important one are having RNA also, like rabies virus, polio virus, retroviruses, HIV or AIDS viruses having the RNA. Coronavirus is also having the RNA. The structural form of deoxyvirus are different. RNA viruses are generally plant virus with a few containing DNA also, like cauliflower mosaic virus. And the types of viruses, like they have categorized HOMAS. HOMAS is a scientist. He categorized the virus into three categories. They are, plant viruses are called phytophagini. Phyto word is used for the plants. Zoophagini is used for the animal virus, and phagini word used for the bacterial virus. And bacteriophages are the virus which infect the bacteria. They are mainly infect lower organism, mainly the bacteria. They were discovered by the Edward Tuart and D. Hurley independently. For example, T2 or T4 lambda phage. The shape of bacteriophage is a tadpole-like, consisting of a head and a tail. There is a connector in between the head and the tail. And the virus multiply after entering into the living cells. The two type of viral reproduction are lytic or lysogenic. Do type ki iske cycles hoti hai, lytic or lysogenic. Tobacco mosaic. Tobacco mosaic, it causes foot and mouth disease. Like there are many human viral diseases also, like polio, rabies, mumps, measles, chickenpox, dengue, elephantiasis, common flu, yellow fever, hepatitis, AIDS, herpes. These are all caused by the virus. Now, viroids. Viroids are actually, they are the infectious agent with a free low molecular RNA or and no protein coat. इनके पास सिर्फ एक लो मॉलिक्यूलर वेट आरएनए होता है, वी कॉल सैटेलाइट आरएनए, और देयर विल बी नो प्रोटीन कोट. दे आर वेरी स्मॉलर देन इवन वायरस. टी ओ डिनर इन 1971 डिस्कवर्ड ए न्यू इन्फेक्शन एजेंट that was smaller than virus and caused potato spindle tuber disease or citrus exocortis disease. Viroids are small circular RNA similar to viroids, but are located inside the protein coat of a true virus. Jo viroids hain, they are having small circular RNA. Viroids require the assistance of virus for their replication. Viroids are free RNA devoid of nucleo protein coat. Inke paas protein coat nahi hota. RNA low molecular weight ka hota hai, tightly fold hota hai, either into circular or linear, single stranded circular. And these prions, the third one is prions. Prions are obligate parasite made up of glycoprotein only. They don't have any DNA or RNA. They are formed due to mutation of gene PRNP. And prions are not affected by proteases, nucleases, temperature up to 800 degrees centigrade, UV radiation and formaldehyde. They have found that they are abnormally folded proteins that cause infection in mainly the neurological disease. They are similar in size to virus. They cause bovines, fungiform, encephalitis or mad cow disease in cattle and C.R. Jacob disease in the humans. So mainly they cause disease by accumulating in the nervous tissue and causing its degeneration. Not much known about the prions. It's a research is going on about the prions and viroids. So if you discuss the difference between the virus and viroids, the virus main thing is that protein coat is present, and viroids, they don't have the protein coat. RNA is comparatively larger. If viruses are having RNA, so comparative size of RNA is large. In viroids, RNA is small. And in virus, the infectious agent might be RNA or DNA. But viroids mein kya hoga? It is always small segment of free RNA. It is not of any DNA. It is always RNA, but it is a short segment. I think it is now clear about you what is virus and viroids. And bacteriophage are the viruses of the bacteria. Now, if you have any question, so because now from my side, this chapter has completed. Okay. So either you will ask some questions or we will start the next chapter. Or I will ask something. So please ask students, they want to ask any question because this chapter is now complete from my side. Algal prepare food for fungi, and fungi provide shelter and absorb mineral nutrients and water for its partner. Lichens are very good pollution indicator. They do not grow in the polluted areas. Okay, that is over from my side. Now I'll ask one question. Batao.